Hey guys, so in this video I want to talk about Call of Duty and how recently, lately, I've been really drawn to not the franchise as a whole, but the game I've been playing a lot is Call of Duty Black Ops, the first one. I still haven't gotten to play the second one, and I really do want to. I do have to say, I'm not generally a huge fan of the first-person shooter genre. I mean, I've had my share of playing a lot of them. You know, I own Killzone 2, Killzone 3, I do own Battlefield Bad Company 2. Back in the days, I used to play on my friend's computer the original Battlefield 2, you know. I think I also play Battlefield 1942, which is like the original, where the Battlefield franchise started. I played Half-Life 2, Half-Life, there's the Fear. There's definitely a lot of first-person shooter games I've played, but it's definitely not like, it's not like my favorite genre to play, you know. Although this genre, I think, has changed in so many. There's so many variations of this genre. There's something like Bioshock. There's something like Deus Ex, Human Revolution. This genre has a lot of varieties to it, you know. So that's why I think it's a pretty fascinating genre. But you know, if there's a genre of games that I gravitate towards, or generally usually, is to like role playing games. Weird downloadable titles, and stealth action games. I love stealth, and generally if I go for shooters, it's generally third-person shooters, or kind of that action-adventure genre. But lately, I come home from my work or my internship, and the game I want to play the most is like, I want to play Call of Duty. And that's what's been happening to me. So I can actually now, and this is weird, I do own Battlefield Bad Company 2, but between the two, I gravitate more towards putting the Black Ops disc in and playing that. Last month, I pretty much replayed the entire Black Ops campaign, single player campaign. I actually really enjoyed it. I like Black Ops campaign a lot. I love the storytelling behind it, and really like the way the ending is, the set pieces that happen, like the Cold War set piece moments. Pretty awesome. Like, I think Black Ops is, like, it's a game that really resonated with me. And Call of Duty as a franchise hasn't resonated with me like that since the first Call of Duty that I played on the computer. That is my second favorite Call of Duty game. I think my most favorite Call of Duty game would have to be Black Ops, the first one. It just really resonates with me. Call of Duty 2, I didn't really like it so much. Call of Duty 3, even less so. Now, Call of Duty 2, I think, it's hard to find really faults or flaws with that game. It just didn't really have too much fun playing that. Call of Duty 4 was pretty, remarkable experience. I didn't really like the multiplayer that much, but 4, I think, had really brilliant moments with the single player campaign. But it was not, like, once I finished it, the replay value for me with that game was gone. So many scripted events. Like, that game is so scripted in so many levels. But I do think it was at least a lot better than Call of Duty Modern Warfare 2. That game has, I think that's probably the least Call of Duty game I played. My least favorite both in terms of single player and multiplayer. Multiplayer now, people are still playing it. You go into Call of Duty Modern Warfare 2 match, it's awful. Like, people have gotten so many hacks. What I noticed is that people have these like dual wielding shotguns, and these are rapid firing dual wielding shotguns. And I hear the sound. It's almost as fast as like a submachine gun. It's ridiculous, but dual wielding shotguns, so really powerful. And if I'm hit with someone dual-wielding shotguns from like a mile away, I still die. Like, I don't even know how this hack is possible, but that's like the scene of Modern Warfare 2. I do not want to go into a match in Modern Warfare 2 because I respawn, I get killed by dual-wielding shotguns, I respawn, then the person who's dual-wielding shotguns has gotten this ridiculous kill streak, and now I die from that kill streak, and it's just respawn, die, respawn, die, respawn, die. Modern Warfare 2 is awful in that sense. And I didn't like the campaign either. The campaigns, like, the set piece moments are just kind of jarring. There are certain, like, Modern Warfare 2 cheats a lot. There are moments where they just throw hordes of enemy AI at you, and you have to just pass through them. Like the mission in Brazil is like the worst. You know, play that mission on the harder difficulties. It's just so aggravating. But Black Ops, I really like. And it's one of those games I can kind of feel the appeal of Call of Duty. You know, after a long day at work or internship, I come home, I want to kick back. And generally, games help you kick back at home once you're back from work. But it's I think I gravitate the most towards like a Call of Duty game because it's just mindless fun. You know, I'm going around shooting people and respawning immediately after I die and just responding to all the things that are going on. Like, I'm not thinking clearly. Like, if I'm playing a Battlefield game, like a match of Battlefield Bad Company 2, yeah, sure, I'm moving around, but I'm also doing a lot of thinking. I'm thinking strategically, like, do I want to place a claymore here? I want to get that vehicle there to help out with my teammates. It's more and more team-oriented, too. Killzone 3, I was playing that, you know, a little bit. And even that has a lot of, like, team-oriented and strategic element to it. And that's not what I want to do. I like to kick back, apparently, it turns out. So I can actually understand the appeal. I can feel the appeal of Call of Duty. It makes sense why it's so popular. And the idea of just, like, earning kill streaks and just... every action you do in Call of Duty is, like, rewarding. Even dying is rewarding. You know, you die a couple of times in a row, and then you make that kill after, like, dying four times in a row. You get extra reward because you just broke your death streak. Like, what? What? Like, you get rewarded for everything. So that mentality, it just feeds you that addiction. I think it makes sense why Call of Duty is like that. And I have to say, I still haven't played it, but I really want to get to play Call of Duty Black Ops 2 sometime. I think I'll really enjoy that. Because I like the Black Ops kind of the premise and the storytelling of it. The Modern Warfare series, I don't know, I've never really have been that big fan of. I haven't played Modern Warfare 3. Don't really feel the interest. I know Ghost is going to be released soon. Yeah, whatever for me. You know, that's not... I still have a kick-ass time with Black Ops. So that's saying a lot. It's still... People are still playing it. I have no problem at all getting connected to a match. It's quick and easy. Yeah, it's a lot of fun, I think. I really do... enjoy a good amount of Call of Duty. It's just mindless fun, you know. It's just kind of, come here, turn the game on, like, turn my brain off a bit, and just kill some virtual people. It's a great stress reliever in some ways. I don't really accrue any stress from playing this game, whereas some other games, like, stress is, like, a big part of it, you know. It's some aspects of some games... Stress is designed. You're supposed to feel a little bit stressful, and that's to engage you, immerse you into the game's universe. Call of Duty doesn't do any of that for me. I just play it, and I just turn my brain off for a sec and just kind of relax. It's a relaxing game in some ways. It's a very casual game in that way, too. Although what I do really like about Black Ops are those kind of hardcore options. There are matches you can get into that have kill streaks turned off, that have equipment turned off, attachments to your weapons turned off. Like, those pure matches, those could be pretty fun too. And the instant respawn turned off. Like, I don't know, I think for some reason, like, Black Ops really resonates with me more so than any other Call of Duty games have. So that's interesting. I don't know.